When reading the Quran, the translators use the terms unbelievers and disbelievers. Will you please clarify the distinction between these two groups of people?
Unbelievers are all those who do not believe in Allah and in His Messenger Muhammad. It is used invariably against pagans, Hindus, Buddhists, and animists. This, in reality, includes all members of the human race who are not believers in Allah, the Muhammadan Arabian version of the God of Israel. Disbelievers, on the other hand, are the Jews and Christians who did not and do not accept Muhammad's cult belief system, but already know the one and only God of Israel and Jesus. Muhammad and his Quran had declared total and unremitting war 1400 years ago against all of humanity unless and until they are all converted, subjugated, or slaughtered. The Quranic verses are very clear, precise, unambiguous, deadly, and totally immoral and disgusting. If the Almighty wanted humanity to believe in Him and only Him, He would have easily programmed them to grovel to Him forever. The Almighty does not need either Muhammad nor his ignorant and murderous followers to force humanity to believe in Him. To suggest that He does is the ultimate profanity and blasphemy. Chapter 2, verse 190. Fight in the cause of Allah. وَقَاتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلَ اللَّهِ Those who fight you. 191. And slay them. وَاقْتُلُوهُمْ Wherever you catch them. 193. And fight them. وَقَاتِلُوهُمْ On until there is no more tumult or oppression. Many Muhammadan scholars do their best to hide the actual message of the Quran of universal subjugation to the will of Allah by misleading people who are ignorant of the Arabic language, of the Quran and Hadith, as well as of the historical record of Muhammad, into believing that these Quranic messages pertained only to the time of Muhammad in his struggle against the pagan Arabs whose beliefs, religion, and traditions he was insulting, denigrating, and attacking. This is, of course, an incredible and demonstrable lie, since his followers conquered, subjugated, slaughtered, and enslaved millions of people on three continents who never heard of Arabs or had any aggression against them. Therefore, slaughtering the unbelievers is not restricted to the pagan Arabs, but to all those who do not believe in the message of Muhammad. All Hindus, Zoroastrians, animists, Christians, polytheists, Buddhists, Jews, etc., anywhere and everywhere on earth. Chapter 4, verse 76. Those who believe fight in the cause of Allah. يُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سَبِيلَ اللَّهِ And those who reject faith fight in the cause of evil. يُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ التَّاغُوتِ So fight ye, فقاتلوا, against the friends of Satan. Those who reject faith are obviously all humans who do not follow Muhammad or his message. Chapter 5, 51. O ye who believe, take not the Jews, Yahud, and the Christians, Nasara, for your friends and protectors. They are but friends and protectors to each other. And he amongst you, that turns to them for friendship is of them. Chapter 8, 55. For the worst of beasts in the sight of Allah are those who reject Him. They will not believe. لا يؤمنون. Chapter 8, 67. It is not fitting for an apostle that should have any prisoners of war until he has thoroughly subdued the land. Allah, the God of Muhammad, the most merciful and compassionate, forbids Muhammad from taking prisoners of war from among the unbelievers. Allah would rather have them slaughtered by Muhammad and his thugs. Chapter 9, verse 5. But when the forbidden months are past, then fight and slay, faqtulu, the pagans, mushrikeena, wherever you find them, and seize them, beleaguer them, and lie in wait for them in every stratagem of war. Chapter 9, 29, slaughter, قاتلوا those who believe not in Allah, nor the last day, nor hold that forbidden which has been forbidden by Allah and His Apostle, nor acknowledge the religion of truth, that is Islam, even if they are of the people of the book, until they pay the jizya with willing submission and feel themselves humiliated. Al-Tabari, chapter 986, explains, Do not seduce the Jews or Christians, for incumbent on them is to pay the jizya, protection tax. The Muhammadan conquerors needed to levy taxes on their victims and did not want them to convert and hence be absorbed. Chapter 9, verse 30. The Jews call Uzair a son of Allah, and the Christians call Christ the son of Allah. That is a saying from their own mouths. In this, they but imitate what the unbelievers, الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, of old used to say. Allah's curse be on them. How they are deluded away from the truth. Chapter 9, 73. O Prophet, strive hard, jahid, against the unbelievers, al-kufara, and the hypocrites, munafiqeen, and be firm against them. Their abode is hell, an evil refuge indeed. Chapter 47, verse 4. Therefore, when you meet the unbelievers, al-ladina kafaru, smite at their necks. Chapter 71, 26. And Noah said, O my Lord, leave not of the unbelievers, kafirina, a single one on earth. Ladies and gentlemen who are listening, be aware that there is not a single verse in the whole of the Quran that prescribes mercy towards the unbelievers. Chapter 72, verse 15. But those who swerve, unbelievers, they are but fuel for hellfire. There are, of course, many more of such evil, blood-curdling, hate-mongering, and war-mongering verses, if the reader has the stomach to look for them, especially in the Total War section of our website. The Quran is not a holy book. The Quran is a roadmap to total war. The Quran is Muhammad's early version of Hitler's Mein Kampf.